Thanks for clicking on the extended version of my interviews for 13 hours, The Secret Soldiers of Benghazi. You'll remember the story, the 2012 terrorist attack on the diplomatic compound in Benghazi, Libya. But some of the guys behind what happened say you never heard the real story, and they came through Arizona, the headquarters for Harkins Theaters.
How willing are you to die for your country? I'm ready to go right here, right now.
When you're writing the book, it's one thing to relive that. When you're on set and you're watching this thing unfold, was it like being back there? Is it that realistic?
It wasn't really that hard, but you know, when you walked onto the annex compound, I mean, it definitely took you right back there pretty quick.
When you saw it on the monitor, they said, when you're seeing it and watching it in real time, no, it looks like a movie set. But when they go to that monitor that Michael Bay looks at, it does bring it some realism to it. It's odd how much cameras can make things look very real and very vivid.
We need immediate assistance. We are overrun.
Watching the trailer, I think it's a great call on his part. The guys who play you, for the most part, are relatively unknown actors. I think that was a good move because otherwise you might get distracted by who's playing you. Did you guys know who these guys were?
I did. I knew who Pablo was just because of I did watch The Wire quite a bit, and Orange Is the New Black I thought was an entertaining show. Women in prison.
Yeah, you better clarify that.
Women in
you
prison.
Don't have
you
got to
watch.
You
know, if there's gonna be women in prison, I'm gonna be watching that. I mean, how interesting is that? But he, you know, he came across as a very, very good actor with a wide range, at least what I saw. And yeah, I was very excited to have him play me, even though he is 6'5" and I'm 5'10" on a good day. So, but our personalities are the same. And my personality is 6'5", so they gotta have somebody tall.
You have a U.S. ambassador at risk.
The ambassador is in his safe haven. You're not the first responders. You're the last resort. You will wait.
Just sad, because he was trying to do good things there, and people loved him there. And he really believed in the mission. And you know, he was left, and he was left to his own accord. He had trying to improve his security there, and the leadership above him wouldn't listen to him. So it's sad, because his death really was not necessary.
You guys did this regularly. You went into these volatile areas. Mm. You sacrificed your lives over and over. Why? From an outsider looking in, you couldn't pay me to go to Benghazi or some of these places. Why?
It's kind of like we were the six brothers. I mean, I put it as brothers, because that's what we are. We're brothers. I mean, we argue, we fight, but let anybody else from the outside, you know, attack Chris, then, you know, they got to deal with me and John, and vice versa is how it works. And that camaraderie, that kinship, you don't get that anywhere else. And, and being able to do something and help other people and protect people, it just brings you a satisfaction, because you know that you can do stuff that most people can't or don't want to do.
And it's more exciting over there. It gets boring in the States, to be honest with you. When you get through those crisis situations and you can feel that, almost like that sixth sense where things are vivid and things are just that adrenaline rush more than anything. And you come back to the States, everything's kind of dull, to be honest with you. And so it's nice to get over there and you feel like you're in your element.
There's a lot, obviously, politically going on right now. What do you hope people get from this movie? What is the main goal for you?
I'll just, bring the story back to the reality of it, which is that we lost four Americans and not the politics of it. You know, that was our main goal, is to leave the politics out of it and, you know, honoring the four guys that lost their lives and sacrificed for the country.
Same. Yeah, I agree. I mean, it got hijacked, and for everybody else's reasons, for their personal reasons, and they didn't give the respect and the honor to the four Americans that served. And there's guys, you know, we have 280, 70 odd diplomatic outposts around the world. And there's guys like Ambassador Stevens out there doing this every day. There's guys like Chris and John out there doing this every day. And they're not doing it for recognition, but it needs to be known that there's people out there doing this and serving this country in that manner. And that's what got lost in this whole thing.
Did the families reach out to you guys just to ask you to sit one-on-one and go, just tell us everything that took place?
We actually, when we were able to, and we had the clearance to do it, we were able to actually reach out to them. So we did, and we did tell the truth, some of the things that they didn't know for over a year. Wow. And it's hard. It's difficult to go and say, you know what, this didn't happen. This is what actually happened to your son. But it's the truth. You gotta be a good leader, and you gotta tell the truth, whether you know the consequences and they hurt you and the emotions hurt you. You gotta do it.
I hope you enjoyed our cast interviews for the film 13 Hours, The Secret Soldiers of Benghazi. It is an incredible film. Everyone should see it. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And in the meantime, we'll see you at the movies.